everyone, welcome back to maths class. Lesson number 9, word problems, addition and subtraction, part 2. Children, in lesson number 9, word problem part 1, we learn addition word problems. Today, in part 2, let us learn subtraction word problems. Children, I have explained to you in part 1 that word problems gives us some information and they ask us to find something. When questions of mathematics are presented in the form of a story, we call them word problems. Inside the story, there are numbers which we need to use to solve the problem. So, in short, we have to understand clearly what information given is and what we have to find out, and then we have to find the answer. Children, subtraction word problems are easy to follow just as the addition word problems. Before we start, just remember that there are several names of subtraction. For example, how many are left? How many are more? Take away, differences, remaining, less, decrease, etc. One of these words when come in word problem, then we have to do subtraction. Let's see exercise given on page number 48. Now children, first we have to read given word problem carefully and understand the question. Then see the given information and what we have to find out. First sum, Abdul had 720 beads. He sold 648 of them. How many beads does he have left? Now in this word problem, given information is Abdul had 720 beads and he sold 648 of them. And now we have to find out how many are left. Now children, this word left stands for subtraction. Means this sum is a subtraction sum. Now we have to write the statements. Given information, we are going to write in the form of statement. Now, since both the numbers are 3-digit number, I had already drawn a box with 100 tens and unit. Now, given information, we have to fill in this box. So, number of bits Abdul had, 720. Then, number of bits Abdul sold. He sold 648 bits. Since this sum is a subtraction sum, we have to put subtraction sign here. Now we'll start solving this sum from units place. 0 minus 8 is not possible, children. So we have to borrow 1 from this 10. So these 2 will turn in 1 and these 0 will become 10. Now 10 minus 8 gives us 2. Now we have to move to the tens. Now here 1 minus 4. Again 1 minus 4 is not possible. So we have to borrow 1 from hundreds. So this 7 will become 6 and this 1 will become 11. Now 11 minus 4, 7. Now we have to move to the hundreds. Here 6 minus 6, 0. So here our answer is 72. Number of bits left is equal to 72. Here in answer we have to write 72 bits left. Bits are left with Abdul. Children, again I am reminding you, this answer is very necessary. In this word problem, statement and answer both are very important, both are very necessary. Let's see the second sum. Joseph bought table worth rupees 6,350 and chairs worth rupees 3,800. How much more did the tables cost than the chairs? Now children, we have to see first the given information and what we have to find out. Now here given information is tables worth rupees 6,350. Children, this sign is rupees sign. And chairs worth rupees 3,800. And then, how much more did the tables cost than the chairs? How much more stand for subtraction? That means, children, this sum is a subtraction sum. Now, I had already written the statement. And since these both numbers are 4 digit, I had drawn a box with 1000, 100, tens and unit. Now, let's fill the information in the box. Cost of tables are rupees 6,350 and cost of chairs rupees 3,800. This word problem is subtraction word problem, so we have to put your subtraction sign. Now we have to start solving from the unit place. 0 minus 0 gives us 0. Now we have to move to the tens. 5 minus 0 is equal to 5. Now we have to move to the hundreds. 3 minus 8 is possible, children? No. So we have to borrow 1 from the thousands. So this 6 will become 5 and this 3 will become 13. 13 minus 8 gives us 5. Now we have to move to the thousands. 5 minus 3 gives us 2. Means the difference is 2,515. So in answer, Joseph paid rupees 2,550 more for the table. Children, this answer is very necessary. Now let's see the third sum. Raghav Rao bought seeds worth rupees 3,587 and fertilizer worth rupees 4,655. How much more than the seeds did the fertilizer cost? Now children, your given information is what? Seeds worth rupees 3,587 and fertilizer worth rupees 4,655. And how much more than the seeds the fertilizer cost? How much more means this sum also a subtraction sum. Now children, given information we have to write in the form of statement. Since the both numbers are four digit number, I had already drawn a box with 1000, 100, tens and units. But children, if you see carefully, see here, the number of fertilizer cost is bigger number than the seeds cost. So in subtraction, always we have to write a bigger number up or bigger number first, and then we have to subtract a smaller number from a bigger number. Cost of fertilizer is rupees 4,655. Then cost of seeds rupees 3,587. Since it is subtraction sum, we have to put subtract sign. Then we have to start solving sum from the units place. 5 minus 7 is not possible, so we have to borrow 1 from 10. So this 5 will become 4 and this 5 will become 15. 15 minus 7 is equal to 8. Now we have to move to the tens. Again here, 4 minus 8 is not possible, so we have to borrow 1 from hundreds. So this 6 will turn into 5 and this 4 will become 14. 14 minus 8 gives us 6. Now we have to move to the hundreds. 5 minus 5 gives us 0. Now we have to move to the 1000. 4 minus 3 is equal to 1. So difference is 1068. The fertilizer cost rupees 1068 more than the seed. Children, I hope you understand the sums which I had explained you. Please solve given exercise on page number 48 in maths notebook and practice it in rough book. This is for today. Thank you. Have a nice day.